you get to put yourself literally at the edge of what Mother Nature and this earth can do, which is take a single little speck, turn it into a cloud, then turn it into a thunderstorm, and then when you got the right ingredients, it just turns it into this monster of a storm that can make a tornado or baseball-sized hail or anything that seems to defy what a normal day is like, right? It's hard to, you know, some people have these big weather events that they're like, this was it. It was this tornado or this hurricane that, you know, that's why I want to be a meteorologist. And some people just really like weather. That's kind of how I am. There wasn't one big event that came up.
They certainly come to us with a fascination about weather that maybe was something that happened when they were 5 years old or 7 years old. A lot of times it's a hurricane for coastal residents. A lot of times it's a tornado.
I think it stems from me being afraid of weather as a kid. And so anytime wind picked up, temperature changed a little bit, anything was out of the norm, I freaked out. And so my mom always, it was kind of a comfort to me to turn on the TV and see a meteorologist telling me everything's fine, there's nothing going on.
We were visiting some relatives and a tornado warning and the NOAA weather radio going off and me being kind of freaked out about what that was and then wanting to learn more. I guess I was always somewhat inquisitive, trying to figure out more about something as opposed to kind of not being afraid of it. And I think that's partially why I ended up kind of in weather.
Anybody that's driven past campus has seen the A&M building and the big radar that's on top. So during active weather, students get to go up there, they get to start up the radar, they get to look at the radar data, they get to interpret it, they get to do all those things right there. And then for the broadcasting side, there's what they get to do on the green screen. So, you know, the forecast that goes to KAMU, they do a radio forecast that goes out across, I think, 10 or 16 counties as well. There's so many hands-on things that these students get to do now that even I didn't get to do while I was in school. So what's really cool about A&M is the National Weather Service or the Storm Prediction Center can call up to the meteorology department and say, hey, we need a balloon launch today. And the students get to actually go out, do the whole process themselves, gather that data that is given to, you know, professional forecasters who use that to make sure that we can keep the public safe.
Howdy, Chris. This is Texas A&M. We're looking to do a balloon launch. Do we have clearance? All right, thanks a lot. All right, you've got clearance to launch. And we are green on all three screens, so let her rip.
Three, one.
Let it go.
Man, that is racing.
We're probably 50 knots at like 950.
Howdy, Brazos Valley. Let's take a look at your Tuesday. We're starting off, it's wet and cold all day long.
I always look forward to class, even though I do get nervous. I thought it was a cool opportunity, something that I've never done. And I'm in the broadcasting club, but I'm a producer. So I'm behind the camera doing all the behind the scenes things. So getting to be in front of the camera was really cool. Our program is really small. It's a really tight-knit community. So getting to do things like storm chasing with my classmates who have become my best friends, getting the opportunity to get on the green screen and practice broadcasting, all the different opportunities that A&M has given me to practice this craft, I think has made me love it even more because yes, it's a lot of math, yes, it's a lot of physics, but it's more than that. It's a hands-on major too, and that's something I was looking for. And so it's just a combination of all those things that have made me kind of fall in love with weather.
Everything about the program has changed my life and has made me so much more confident. It's something special about having a group of people that you can relate to and a group of people that grew up in a similar way as you. Like, I just feel so much comfort, like, in this building because I know that everybody in this building, like, has similar goals as me. And, like, they're not, they were called weird when they were a kid, too, just like me. But we're not weird. We're cool.
What's your average?
I'm looking at about an average of about 10, 11, 9, 10, 11.
Like many fields, there's an expectation that that bachelor's degree means you are ready to do some to do some work. We take very seriously that charge to make sure that graduates are ready to save lives and property.
If we can be the ones to help people plan their day better, help keep people safe when there is danger coming, help people feel more comfortable about living in a certain region as climate may be changing or as things might be evolving, then we have accomplished our goal.
Sure, the weather and the science of it is cool, but essentially you become a meteorologist because you do want to make sure that people know what's coming, know what's happening, right? It's not a perfect science, but we can give you a pretty good idea that, hey, on this day, there's going to be big storms. You need to pay attention because they could be destructive or maybe even deadly.
But coming pretty close, and it's going to be right here. This is the Navasota River.
So I think that that is the biggest thing that I look for, and that I think I see in a lot of Aggies as well. It's just that passion to want to help people, because that's essentially what we're doing as meteorologists. No matter where you are in all 50 states, guaranteed that in some way, shape, or form, you're getting an Aggie meteorology forecast.